My love story with Augustus, Adam Augustus Renzi, began at my friend Joanna Prisco's bachelorette party. She wanted to have 12 women at an Anirondack Lake house at her aunt and uncle's home. Her cousin, Adam Augustus Renzi, was asked to be the cabana boy for the weekend.
So I agreed, reluctantly, even though I had probably dreamed about having myself and 12 women alone at the lake for the entire span of my life, but it, you know, took until I was 45 to make it happen.
So Adam kind of had his dream come true by this invitation to a bachelorette party, and that's where we met. The first time I saw Augustus, it was uncomfortable familiarity. He was sitting in the great room of the lake house, a tall, handsome, bald man playing guitar. I was immediately uncomfortable.
And I remember walking in and seeing random girls all over the place. And at one moment I look over and I see, it was Angela, but at the time I didn't know. And I was like, that's the girl that reminds me of my Aunt Jeanette. And even as I said it, I was like, I don't know a girl that reminds me of Aunt Jeanette, but okay.
My husband, Rich, was a tall, bald man who played guitar. And he was killed in a car accident.
So as the weekend progressed, I noticed, you know, Angela more and more, that she was, something about her, it was just really sweet and just made me interested in her.
I sort of created some distance between us because I was so uncomfortable. But the attraction and the chemistry was too strong. And I didn't see Augustus again until Joanna's wedding.
In the meantime, my buddy Lawrence had been always mentioned, like, I think you and Angela, I think there was some connection there. And I was like, well, I don't know, whatever. So just to kind of shut him up, I'm like, when the day of the wedding comes, if she comes alone, single, I'll make sure I ask her to dance on the first dance.
And he asked me to dance and brought me to the bar and gave me my first kiss. And that was really extraordinary.
I just planted it on her. I just went for it. And then we danced the rest of the night and all that other magic happened. You can't really, I can't explain it, but we'll keep that part private.
And then things moved pretty quickly.
What I like most about Angela is her thoughtfulness, her spiritual connection. Angela's just on point spiritually, and maybe it has something to do with the tragedies that she had in the past, the car accident, her coma, and that little connection to the higher power that maybe you don't have unless you go through those types of things.
What I like so much about Augustus is he is kind, he's loving, he's generous, he's very creative. It's beautiful, the spaces he transforms just by being in them.
She's very much about family and love and joy, so those are things that I really appreciate about her.
He's incredibly honest and trusting and hardworking and fun, a lot of fun.
She just knows how to touch people in a loving way. It comes back to her. In the same way too. So that's what I think her biggest value is, thoughtfulness and love.
He makes me a better person, a better woman, a better human being by just being in my life. There's not another human being in this world who I value and appreciate and respect as much as I do Augustus Renzi.
And I want her to know that all the years between now and when she might see this again in far distant future, that I've loved her the entire time, and all those memories I'll keep with me as long as I can keep memories. She brings it all, 100%.
Augustus says that my husband Rich helped bring us together. He helped guide us together in that Adirondack Lake House where our love story began. I want to continue to have faith that we continue to be the symbol for a lot of people to know that when there is loss and something might seem like it's at an end, that it truly can be the beginning of something even more amazing. And this is my even more amazing. Woo!
I now introduce to you to Mr. and Mrs. Augustus and Angela Renzi. Congratulations. High fives and hallelujah.